Howdy all, welcome to tonight's Lockdown 3, Quiz 3. Nice to see you all on there. There's 15 players on there so far, so that's good. Yeah, it's good. You can probably see I'm looking a little bit better than last week, even on the sauce. There you go. All the way from Pontypridd. Yes, sold Orchard Gold. Yeah, I didn't go to Pontypridd though, because that would be breaking the rules, wouldn't it? That would be like 3 hours drive. But courtesy of TESCO, can't say that because it might do me for copyright or something. And who wants to advertise supermarkets when we can't go out to bloody pub? You've probably all seen the news today. I think Drakeford was a little bit scarce on his roadmap of getting out of lockdown. But you've got me for quite a little bit longer by the look of it. So that's all good, isn't it? Yeah, that's all good. I see we've got 20 teams, 21 teams now. Oh, brilliant. It's going up fast. Yeah, you know, for some reason, when I look back on these videos, not that I watch myself, because that's just weird. There's like 144 people viewing these, but there's only 34 teams. So somebody in the world or the country are sat there watching little old me in the house. Well, that's quite cute. But if you're watching this now and you're not playing the game, why don't you play the game? And if you want to, just got to do this. Yeah, go to Quizbit. Type in RO4687 and then enter your name and you can be on there. A few messages coming through on the live chat, which if you've got that option, feel free to send me a message. I'll try and reply to each one. Louise Myers, hello. Hello, Louise. Thank you for sharing my post earlier. That's all it's about, ladies and gents. Share this. Share it. You know, it's for everyone. You know, and that's what it's about. You know, keep your fun. Paige Brindley, hello as well. XX, back to you. Louise didn't put me a kiss, just put me an exclamation mark. It's a bit harsh. Paul Roberts, you feeling better? Yes, Paul, I'm feeling a lot better. A little bit still in the nose, but it's a big nose, so it takes a while to clear, all right? So thanks for the concern, though. Louise Myers, where's our picture of Johnny Depp? I couldn't find any pictures of Johnny Depp. I really couldn't. I'm going to be honest, I didn't look. I told you anyway, it was going to be Barbarella, if anything. Louise, thank you. She sent me some kisses now. So kisses back to you. I'm not going to do as many. This guy, she sent me about 30 kisses there. The wife's going to get a bit jealous there, Louise. All right, she's in front of her own. No, she's playing tonight as well. She's going to play tonight, but she can't see any of the answers. Okay, so if she wins, doubtful. Just what it is. Yeah, we've got loads of teams. 27 teams, that's good. If don't mention what, I'll go through Quizbees, the Ghoulies, Hobgoblin Queen, Little Old Wine Drinker Me, Mother Futters, the Italians. Are you in Italy or just Italian? Doesn't matter either way. But thanks for joining. Nana's back, Grifter's back, the Beers. Obviously, they won last week, didn't they? So you've got to beat them this week, everyone. Like I said, there's a 50 quid bar tab up for grabs for whoever wins the most times. So it's worth playing, isn't it? You know, and Rebel Scum, Mrs. S, we've got just Jazz Hands again. There we are. I can't see the rest of them. Mrs. Smith just joined the game. Like I said, it only lets you see so many. Now, you might see a little variation in the bottom right-hand corner. It says go live. Now, this might be a new option Elliot at Quizbits put together. It's basically, instead of me being on YouTube, I can press go live and I'm on your device. Like a tablet or whatever. The only thing I think that might not work, because I think a lot of you might like seeing me on your TV. I don't know, maybe not. Maybe you do. But I guess if I go for that option, go live, you won't be able to watch me on the TV. And if you watch me on the TV, you can't answer the questions, can you? So I don't know how it's going to work. It's going to be a trial and error. I'm going to do a few little trials with Mr. James Guy Peck, my good friend and employee. He's going to give it a go anyway. We'll see how it works. I like sticking on YouTube, but they always release something different. But yeah, don't click that live button, whatever you do, because it might crash the system. Now, I noticed last week that some people couldn't log in because of kwbit.com. If you remember when I put in the comments, it was on obviously the Facebook page and the Google messages and business and all that. I put in there, you need to wipe your cache. No, that problem is there. It wasn't recognizing kwbit.com. Now, if your computer does it, great. If it doesn't, just log into Quizbit. Yeah, just type in Quizbit. Forget the .com. I had troubles with it on Wednesday when I tried to do a little trial as well. So yeah, so ignore kwbit.com, it's not working. Quizbit, so KWIZZBIT, that'll get you onto the same site, and you're sending the details same as normal. Two likes, I like it. Keep liking, loving it. You know, we need more of them. Yeah, share these as many times as you can so we get some more players. We're up to 31 teams. We're averaging about 30, 34 teams at the minute. So that's still good. And it keeps you entertained. I mean, what else are you going to do on a -2 night? You know, nothing. Not going to sit in the garden, are you? But never fear, ladies and gentlemen, spring is around the corner. Yay! So this is like deja vu. It was only like yesterday. It was spring and summer again. And we're all sat in the garden last year. God, how quick has this year gone? Well, anyway, like I said, if you want to join in the quiz tonight, the code is R04687. And just go to Quizbit or quizbit.com, whichever works for you. Yeah, we'll give it a couple of minutes. Just let a few more people join in. And there's a lot of different people on there tonight who haven't played before, which is ace. I did advertise it with my company. Hopefully some of them have joined in. I don't know. Yeah, we'll see. Like I said, what else are we going to do? Right, tonight's quiz, got lots of different rounds. Got a few different quizzes on tonight. We've got six rounds. I can't remember every single one of them, but I know we've got music mix, which is cool. Okay, we've got colours, whatever that'll be. Then we've got sitcoms. I did mention sitcoms last week, so we've added that one in there tonight. And the general run affair type things, general knowledge. So absolutely amazing. So it should be great. There's 12 questions in every round. And if you haven't played before, the last question, obviously number 12 in every round, is the evil question. Now, like I said, if you haven't played before, it's a bit of a difference one that. If you don't answer it, you're going to lose some points. If you answer it right, you're going to get loads of points. If you answer it wrong, you're going to lose points. So just easy as that. But yeah, there's a feature in the system where the faster you answer it, the more points you're going to get. Okay, so if you answer it within a second, you're going to get, I think it's 190 points. I think it's 10 points for every second and goes down and down and down and down. So that's how it works, if you weren't sure, if you haven't played before, but the rest of you are all, you're all, you've played for a long time now, and it was at quiz 32 now. So you should know the rules. At the end of round three, we have a little break and we all go for a little bit of a drink, have a cigarette, whatever you're going to do. And then we'll play a little bit of music for you. Got a little bit different than music tonight than the normal Northern Soul fare that I always give you. So hopefully you'll like a little bit more of a upbeat music tonight. But yeah, right, okay. Well, time is, can't see the time. Oh, it's 36 minutes past. So right, I advertise it for 8:30. I'll give you enough time to join in. So at the minute, we're standing at 32 teams. Push it up. New team. I don't think I've seen Push It Upper before. Mr. Johnson's just joined in. So I say, you're all running late tonight. What have you all been up to? Hey, whatever you've been up to, I hope you've been staying safe and well. And thank you for joining me on the quiz. It's an hour and a bit, hour and a quarter, maybe something like that, if I don't waffle on too much like I'm doing now. I haven't seen Juan Sheets. I haven't seen him join in yet. But if you have joined in, welcome back, Juan Sheets. And welcome to all of you anyway. Right, let's get this quiz on the go. Like I said, I've got some music tonight, so you can actually hear some sound effects. And hopefully you're not getting any crackling. Somebody dropped me a message. Is there any crackling tonight? I don't think there will be, because I'm using my old computer tonight, so it should be fine. Right, so let's get the quiz on the go anyway. It's 35 teams. There you go. One more than last week. Fantastic. It's Linz. Yeah, Linz. Where have you been, Linz? Yeah, always late to the party. Better late than never, though. Right, let's crack on anyway. So let's start the event. Like I said, 12 rounds. So welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. If Miami Tornadoes are on there, they were smashing it the other week. Don't forget, they're only 9 and 10-year-olds. So anyone get these answers. But good luck to everyone. And Beers, let someone else win. Well, don't let her win, but yeah, let's give the Beers a run for the money, yeah? Phil and Ali. Now, James Peck, you said, no crackling tonight, boss. We're having chicken. We're having chicken. There's no crackling. You're obviously not having pork, are you? Ba-doom! Back of the net. No crackling. There we are. I'm on form tonight. See, I'm not poorly. Right, let's have a look. And hopefully, James, you're feeling better. James was feeling bad last week. Don't forget, he was laid up with, well, I won't say what, But yeah, he wasn't very well. So hopefully you're better. And you can call me later and we'll have a little chat. All right. Love you, James. Right. First round is mystery. 12 questions covering, well, you'll soon find out. Yes. You might be able to tell as well. I've had a little COVID cut. I did it myself. Messed it up completely. And Steph fixed it. Now, I should have waited 20 minutes and Steph would have done it in the first place. Yes, I looked a little bit like Lloyd out of Dumb and Dumber. There's a bit of a ball cut going on. But hey-ho. Oh, James just says, still not sitting right. Literally, hey-hey-ho. There you go. We won't go there, James. We don't want to know what your ailments are. We wish you know you better, or slightly better. Right, let's crack on with the quiz anyway. Right. Boom. Rock and roll, eh? Right, in 1982, comedian Spike Milligan was sacked as VIP ambassador for Keele University students. How much did the job pay per year? Right, pick one of them. Like I said, you've got four possible answers, so just pick the one you think's right. The faster you do that, the more points you're going to get, all right? I'm going to turn this up a little bit. If you say it's too loud your end, let me know. Okay, just to calm down music, okay? Right, okay, the answer we were looking for was one penny. Yeah, seven of you got that right. Okay, £100, six people thought that. £1,000, seven thought that. And 15 people thought it was £1. Mr. Tim Cowell, Mr. Tim C. I don't know if you can see him on your system, but yeah, you got the fastest finger bonus for that one. So if you haven't played the quiz before, I always let you know who got the fastest finger bonus. And if you got him all wrong, I'm not going to tell you. It'll be fine. You'll know. You'll see on your computer anyway. Right, question two. Name the 90s cartoon. So I'm going to send you a picture or a picture and just name it. One of the four options. Ready? Go. And boom. There you go. Easy peasy, this one. Many, many hours watching this. Cheers, all. Now, that took you less than 2 seconds to answer, everyone, so you must be really up in your cartoons, and you must be all not millennials. The answer was Rugrats. Of course it was Rugrats. 35 of you got it right. One person said the raccoons. How possibly did Angelica look like a raccoon? But that was your option to press, so sadly you lost points on that one. But it's all in the next questions, and points add up. Faster you think you answer, the more points you're going to get. Okay, but anyway, question three. How many cards are there in a standard pack of tarot cards? Not normal cards, tarot cards. So type the number. You should have a little keypad on your system, phone, tablet, laptop, whatever you're using. It's happening. Tarot cards. Okay, right, well, four people answered this one right. 32 of you didn't get it right, unfortunately. And if you wouldn't, before I give you the answer, if you wonder why I'm not wearing my sparkly jacket tonight, because my little cat down here, Bamba, she sat on it and she looks so comfortable, I don't want to move her. You know, she's a timid little cat, and when she gets comfy, don't move her. Yeah, but I can't show you because I'll mess up. Oh, I can show you anyway. Hang on.
I'm back.
Anyone see the cat? There she is. Hello. Oh, bless her. Oh, it's always nice to show you my animals. We all love cats. Well, you hope you do. If you don't, log off. I'm only joking. Don't log off. I want you to play. Right. Okay. So the answer we're looking for was 78. The 78 cards in a standard tarot pack. Whoa, it's amazing. They almost take their mediums quite well to do that. That's why they charge you £100 an hour. There we are. Right, okay, so next question. Question four. Choose two of these, though. Choose two. Which two colours are not found on the eBay logo? I'm going to send you the possible answers now. So which two of them are not found on the eBay logo? I'm sure you all have been using eBay lately, or Amazon. That's what you buy stuff. I get a knock on the door every day from the postman. Yeah, something for Mrs. Harland. Nothing for me ever. Nothing for me ever. Oh, one sheet is on the board tonight. I see you just popped up there. Well done. One sheet is back. Right, the colours that aren't there are pink and black. All right, so if you got that right, well done. 32 of you did, only 4 got it wrong. Fastest finger bonus goes to Linz. Well done, Linz. Oh, Bamba, sit down, don't worry. Oh, she got a bit terrified there. Shouldn't have clapped. Right, question 5. In a standard deck of playing cards, which suit has the only king without a moustache? Aha! Who would have thought these questions up? I have no idea. That's a random one, that. So what standard suit hasn't got a moustache? Moustache. Let's have a look. Right, okay. Hearts was the answer. 16 of you got that right. 8 said spades, 10 said diamonds, and 2 said clubs. But the hearts was the answer, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Grifter, Davey O. Grifter O. Well done, O. Fastest finger bonus to you. Oh, Motherfooters are in. There you go. I see that. The Ghoulies. Oh, I haven't seen you for a while. Oh, well done, the Ghoulies. Let's have a look. Right, question 6. List the following 4 inventions in order. Now, I need this earliest first, okay? These are your possible answers. Earliest first on the 4 inventions. And so on and so on and so on. Sorry, Tim, have you read your message there? Whoop, whoop. Yeah, whoop, whoop. Right back at you, buddy. Whoop, whoop. Okay. Right, it went battery first, jeans second, diesel engine third, and then hovercraft fourth, right? Well, the fastest finger bonus goes to Rebel Scum. Well done, Rebel Scum. Okay, well, 7 of you got that right, and 29 of you got it wrong. Never mind, no, don't worry about it. Okay, so if you want to know a little bit of a quiz fact, Alexandro Volta battery, 1799. Levi Strauss jeans was 1850. Rudolph diesel engine was 1892. And Christopher Cockerill hovercraft was 1955, if you wanted to know. I knew that off the top of my head. Of course, I did not. It's up on the screen. It's fine. Right, okay, so next question. Question 7. Heinz baked beans are branded with the misleading number of how many varieties? So Heinz baked beans are branded with a misleading number of how many varieties? 21, 47, 57, or 65? Right, okay. Well, that's quite fast. Answer was 57. 30 of you got that right. 2 people thought it was 65. 3 teams thought 47. 1 team thought 21. Fastest finger though, Paige Bradley. Well done, Paige. Yeah. And if you wonder why I'm wearing my yellow jumper, because someone said, you look far better in a summery colour. And I thought it'd cheer up because it's horrible and cold outside. So, summery. Who needs a sparkly jacket? Bamba can keep it for now. All right. For now. All right. Question 8. In rugby union, how many yards positions is a team penalised for arguing with a referee's decision? Okay, keypad, just type in the answer. See, I love rugby, and I'm sure I'll enjoy Wales v Scotland tomorrow, especially because the wife's Scottish, and I'm now majority Welsh, aren't I? So we'll see what happens there tomorrow. But I can't remember, is that union or league? Doesn't matter, as long as Wales win. Oh, heard the wife there. Scotland to win, apparently. Wow, Wales to win, of course they are. Even though with the injuries we've got, you'll still smash it. I'm sure we will. Okay, right. 10 of you got it right. 26 of you sadly got it wrong. The answer we're looking for was 10. Yeah, so it's 10 points. Okay. Fastest finger, though. Thicco Paolo. Hello, Thicco Paolo. Well done for that. Fastest finger bonus goes to you. I can tell you just right halfway through this quiz, the beers are smashing it. So we need to pip them, guys. You know, if you want to win that overall £50 bar tab for when we open. So remember, get the fastest finger first. Not that I'm dishing you, Phil and Ali. Bit of competition. Never hurt anyone. Okay, question 9. Name the TV show from the classic car. So I want to send you a picture. So what is the TV show from this classic car picture? Easy peasy. If anyone gets this wrong, warn me, Ties. You answered it really fast, so I don't think anyone's going to get this one wrong. Really, guys? Come on. Right, Knight Rider, 34 people said that. One person said Miami Vice. One person said Magnum. And nobody said A-Team. I'm not going to name and shame who got that one wrong, okay? But the fastest finger bonus goes to the wins. It was Kit out of Knight Rider, Michael Knight, and then Knight, like 2000. That was a bit rubbish, that one, actually. But yeah, Knight Rider, come on. Somebody just sent me some messages here. Man, I pressed the wrong button. James Peck said he pressed the wrong button. Oh, of course you did. Excuses. A bad workman always blames his tools. Yes. Good job. We'll do street art next. See if you get that one. We're not going to do that. Question 10. What is the bodyguard character played by Kevin Costner in the 1992 film The Bodyguard? What's his name? Frank Farmer, Frank Kavanagh, Frank Baker, or Frank Butcher?
I love you, Pack.
You're doing a lot of thinking about that one, really? Okay, well, no, that's a problem. Let's have a look. The answer we were looking for was Frank Farmer. So 11 of you got that one right. 18 thought it was Frank Kavanagh, 6 thought it was Frank Baker, and one person thought it was good old Frank Butcher out of EastEnders. Sadly not. But the Lockdown 3, fastest finger bonus, welcome to the quiz Lockdown 3. If you played it before, I apologise. I just don't get to see all the teams. It only shows me the top 10. They all come in order when you join in, but I can't go back that far. Just Louise Myers, are you doing Singleton's Prize 2, Chris? Or is Poole alone, some people are unknown? No, I'll tell you what, Louise, I'll sit and have a drink with you. We'll have a meal, we'll have a hobgoblin, and we'll share it. Now, of course, you can spend it yourself, or bring someone if you find someone. Not a problem. If you don't, not to worry. Right, question 11. How many red elements are there on a standard dartboard? Okay, so on a standard dartboard, how many red elements are there? That's red sections. Cheers, everyone. No, it took a while there. Right, 33 of you got this one wrong, ladies and gents. Only 3 teams got this one right. The answer was red was 21. There's 21 red elements on a dartboard. Look what you could have won. In one. There we are. In 21, actually. There we are. Evans 11. Well done, though. You got the fastest finger. Now, I invited a few people from up north to play this quiz today. I'm not sure if they're all playing because they didn't put the real names. But if they have, I haven't seen them. But if there is anyone from Redcar playing or Millsborough, or anywhere up northeast, welcome to the Welsh quiz. We do our best down here. All right, so get yourselves down when lockdown's over. Okay, if you want to text me later saying you did play the quiz, I'm here all evening, but we're going anywhere. Okay, right, question 12. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, this is the evil question. So you have to answer it right. If you don't, you're losing lots of points. If you don't answer it, you're going to lose the points as well. If you answer it right, bonus, more points. Okay, so what is the 12th question? It is, who was the designer of the Spitfire who passed away just 12 months after a plane took to the air? Well, the 4 possible options, was it Alec Boeing, Reginald Mitchell, Sir George Cayley, or Wilbur Wright? So he designed the Spitfire and he passed away 12 months afterwards. Probably didn't get to see Luca Harland. There we are, Luca. Hi, Chris. It's Luca. Me and Mams are playing. Welcome, Luca and Claudia. Nice one, Claudia. That's the Italian. That's it. I knew it was probably you. I knew it was. Yes. Good on you. Yeah. Where's Lana? Anyway, glad to see you on the quiz anyway. Hopefully you're enjoying it. And it's nice to see me. I guess I haven't seen you for 2 years now since the wedding. So it's nice to hopefully you can see me. So that's good. Enjoy the quiz, guys. Right. Let's have a look. That's around end of that round. The end of the question was Reginald Mitchell. Only 19 of you got that right. 3 people thought it was Albert Boeing. 7 said Sir George Cayley. And 7 thought it was Wilbur Wright. But fastest finger bonus on the end of that round goes to Rebel Scum. Well done, Rebel Scum. Okay, so I'm going to list it. We've got lots of teams on, so I'm not going to go from 35 all the way down to the number one. But from fifth place, we got Push It Up. Push It Up. You got 1,209 points. Well done. Fourth place is the Beers. I'm only joking. I'm not mocking. You're on 1,301 points. Horan Sheets is in third place with 1,311 points. Second place is Mother Footers. There you go. I said footers, yeah, for all of you young ones out there, Luca. You're not young now anyway, you're well old. 1,311 points, 1,327 points. But in first place is Dave Grifter, 1,393 points. Well done, Dave, that's a good score. Ollie's are scoring really well tonight. So yeah, keep them fastest finger bonuses, because don't forget, we play against the nation. You know, it's not just Wales, it's not just the Nag's Head. A lot of other people play this quiz throughout the country because they're all locked up, same as you guys and girls, boys and girls, yes. So just get the fastest finger in there. And I know they send out prizes for the number one in the nation. So be in it to win it. That's what it's about. Someone's joining late. The code is, I'm just going to give someone else the code because someone's joining late, but they can still catch up, ladies and gentlemen, is R046. 84687. There you go. Lovely. I think it's one of my wife's pubs down in Stoke. I think they want to play. How dare they join late? You know, 7:30. Yes, we'll be late to the party. Okay, right. Round two. This is colours. Okay, and we've never done this round before, so I don't know exactly how this works. So let's see. I'm assuming it's about colours. That's all I can say. Let's have a go. All the colours of the rainbow. Well, that probably says on your phone anyway. Right, start the round. Green Street is a road in London associated with which football team? There you go. See, colours, associations. I guess it's what it says in the tin, really, isn't it? Bit of Amorite going on. The millennials, you will not remember the adverts of Amorite. Does exactly what it says in the tin. There you go. Look at that message here. Coming from Stock, I better not get it wrong. There you go, Hayley Borden. Thank you for joining. Actually, Steph has given the code. Don't worry if you're running a bit late. It's all about fastest finger there, Hayley. So the faster you answer it. What's that? Oh, it's not Hayley. So we've got another team from Stoke. Totally random. But anyway, Hayley, fastest finger. The faster you answer it, the more points you can get. So you can catch up, okay? And next week, 7:30. All right, okay. So the answer we're looking for was West Ham. 26 of you got that right. 4 teams said QPR. 5 teams said Crystal Palace. And 1 team said Arsenal. Fastest finger does, quiz on my face. Here you go. Well done. Fastest finger bonus for you. So that takes you straight into lead on 203 points. Very good. Okay, question 2. DeWalt power tools are noted for which 2 colour combinations? But DeWalt, what are the 2 combinations for that product? Okay, is it yellow and orange, orange and grey, black and yellow? You can use it. I'm going to read this message. Hayley Borden, I've been here since the start. Lol. All right, sorry, Hayley, I didn't realise. But see, you said Stoke, so I just assumed when the wife said one of our teams from Stoke joining, I thought it was you. But hey ho, thanks for joining in on time, Hayley. Not like the other people in Stoke. Good team, not so much at keeping time of quizzes. Lockdown free. We're all in lockdown free. What's going on? Yes, unless someone's in lockdown, so you just forgot about what's happening over the last 6 months. Now, it is horrible, but we're all here enjoying it. So hopefully you're enjoying the quiz and keep playing every week. And when lockdown's over, you could win that 50 quid bar tab, but you can come down and see what pubs are like in Wrexham. Yes. Okay, right, next question. Moving on quickly there. I haven't even given you the answers. Right, answer was yellow and black. That's the colours of DeWalt. Fastest finger bonus goes to Mr. Johnson, Mr. Billy Johnson, my cousin from up in Middlesbrough with his good wife, Louise. Right, okay. 20 of 9 got that right. 7 of you sadly got it wrong. Not too worried, though. We'll move on to question 3. The name of which colour is derived from the French word mole? Okay. So the name of the colour is derived from the French word mole. Sure that wasn't a French accent, but take off. You'll get what I mean. Cheers. So have a look. Right. Okay. It is top. Yeah, top. 19, we've got that right. Two teams follows Azuri. Four follows Okra. Okra. See, pronunciation isn't my strong point, as you know. Okra, I'm sure I got that right. And 11 for Fawn. Dazval. Dazval, well done, Dazval. Welcome to the quiz. You've got the fastest finger bonus there. Keep that one up. Okay, question four. Type the number on this one, okay? So how many shades of blue are there in the Crayola colour wheel? How many shades of colour are there in the Crayola colour wheel? That's Crayola's little wax pens the kids love drawing all over my tables with, hence I stopped giving them out. Kids will be kids, but I don't like sanding and varnishing, so yeah. Maybe you should design paper tables. Maybe an option, Dragon's Den, paper tables, just rip the top off. There we are. Okay, right, five got this one right, ladies and gentlemen. Only five, 31, just hardly got it wrong. Never mind, don't worry, but I can tell you the answer was 19. There's 19 shades on a Crayola colour wheel. There we are. 50 shades of colour. Little old wine drinker me. There's not me, the little old wine drinker there. She's or he or them. They've got the fastest finger bonus there, so well done. Question five, the Blue Jean Cavern in which British National Park? So the Blue Jean Cavern is in which British National Park? There we are. So I'll show you a picture there, and I'll give you the answers. So is it Snowdonia, Peak District, Dartmoor, or Cairngorms? 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 One of them. Right, you answered quite quick, so you know it better than me. It was Peak District. Yes, it was Peak District. 20 of you got that right, so the majority of people. Seven said Snowdonia, four thought Dartmoor, and five thought it was a Cairngorms. I can't say it. I'm not going to go on with that one. Little old wine drinker. You're on fire, aren't you? Well done, two in a row. There we are. Question six. What colour is the zero on a roulette wheel? Ha-ha, I know this one. What colour is a zero on a roulette wheel? Now, I'll tell you a little fact about the zero in just a minute once you've answered. Okay, right, so it could be black, red, white, or green. If you answered black, four people did, you got it wrong. If you said red, two people did, got it wrong. If you said white, eight people did, you got it wrong. It was green. Yeah, 22 of you got that one right. But the fastest finger goes to Mrs. Johnson, Billy's better half. Yeah, well done. Yeah, quick little story. If I would say a fact, a little story. Me and my wife were in Vegas quite a while ago, and we were watching someone on the roulette table, because obviously roulette, we love it. And someone bet all the chips on zero, and it came in. Fantastic. We were like, wow, well done. Yeah, the odds of that one, you get loads of chips back. And she did, and the next second, I will never believe could happen. But she put them all back on zero. And we were like, and you know what happened? Zero came back in. And she walked away, as you would. Unbelievable. I've never seen something like that happen ever in my life. And I was amazed by it. I just wish it was my money. But hey, yeah, interesting story. Maybe you're not, maybe it isn't. But I thought I'd share that one with you, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. When in Vegas. There we are. Right, question seven. Put the colours of the rainbow in order from the top to the bottom. Yeah. Get this one wrong. Anyway, the blue, green, orange, indigo, which order do they go in? I think if you think about primary colours, it might help. Okay, well, quite quick. Okay, so first we needed orange. Second would have been green. Third would have been blue. And fourth was indigo. So if you got it in that order, well done. The 14 people did get in that right order, and 22 who sadly didn't. The fastest finger went to Paige Brinney, though. Well done, Paige. Ba-doom. Smashing it. Okay, question eight. In which high street store would you associate Wackling Gold? Wackling Gold? No, is that a silent J? I don't know. Jacqueline Gold. Jacqueline? Might be Jacqueline. Anyway, it's up to you to answer it, not Serena decide it. Yeah, you're all taking your time on this one, full 20 seconds. Oh, no, sorry. It took full 18 seconds. Right, okay, answer was Anne Summers. Yeah, so Jacqueline Gold, 21 of you said that right. 9 thought it was Body Shop, 1 thought Warehouse, and 5 thought it was Wallace. But Mr. Johnson, Billy Johnson, well done. Fastest finger bonus for you. Question 9, how many shades of red are there on a Crayola colour wheel? If you get this one wrong, I'll be out of standard. Yeah, exactly. Somebody's just got it wrong. And we've just had this question, ladies and gentlemen. I will bring us up with Elliot down at Quizmit. Why we've got a duplicate question in there. But hey, it gets chances to get your scores up. Randomly enough, 32 of you got it wrong. 4 of you got it right. Okay, so you're obviously not paying attention. But never mind. Oh, hang on. No, see, me mocking you. No, that was the wrong thing to do because it originally was how many shades are there on a Crayola? Yes, my apologies. I shall take it back and I will Hail Mary all the way tonight. I'm sorry for mocking you. Still, 32, you got it wrong. 4 people got it right. I should read my questions a little bit more and pay more attention myself. Naughty boy. Okay, the answer was 23. Okay, win or booze? Well done. No, you got the fastest finger on that one. I'm sure if we had a dislike button at the minute, you'd be pressing it. I'm sure. I'm sorry. Yes. But moving on swiftly, what colour is the live wire in the UK electrical plug? So, what colour is the live wire in the UK electrical plug? Oh, I'm so embarrassed. 50 shades of red. There we are. Ooh, crimson, whatever colour you want to call it. It's one of the shades anyway, isn't it? Okay, right, the answer was brown. So yeah, so the live wire is brown. So you remember that when you're doing a bit of DIY at home. 12 of you got it right, 10 said red, 7 said green, and 7 said blue. Okay, but the fastest answer goes to the Pex. Well done, Pex. They a double team tonight. They only had half a team last week. So she did way better than you, though, Jamesy boy. She did way better than you thought she would. So, right, question 11. In motor racing, what colour flag requires drivers to slow down during a hazard on the track? So what colour is the hazard flag when on the F1? Okay. Or any motor racing. I think it's all the same. If I'm wrong, tell me at the side here, or at the top, or at the bottom. No, all taking your full 20 seconds there. Not too worried on, because if you answer it right, you get the points, don't you? If you answer it wrong, you're not getting it. Okay, right, the answer was yellow. So 25 of you said that one. Somebody sent me a message on the Crayola question. One asked how many blue, the other ones how many red. I think it said how many colours are on the colour board. I think not just blue. I think that was the original question. But thank you for pointing that out. Yes, I was embarrassed enough, but thank you very much, Paige. Even better now. Right, so 25, you said yellow. That was right. Yes, 2 said green, 6 said red, and 3 said white. Fastest finger goes to Louise, though. Well done, Louise. Right, evil question, next question. So you remember what this is about? Answer it, don't answer it, you're losing points. Yeah, so get it right. You're welcome. Paige Brinney, you're welcome. Thanks, Paige. Hey, I don't mind being mocked. I would mock myself anyway. I got it wrong. Right, question 12. The first ever Green Party MP was elected in which city in the 2010 British general election? So I'll send you them possible answers. So was it Burlington, Bristol, Brighton, or Blackpool? Cheers all. Okay, if you said Bridlington, you get it wrong. One person did. 7 said Bristol. That was sorry wrong. 4 said Blackpool. That was sadly wrong. But if you said Brighton, 25 of you did, you got it spot on. Fastest finger bonus goes to Paige Brindley, the mucker of the week. No wrong with that. Poo round. Louise Mann said poo round. It wasn't poo round. You're doing all right. Like I said, it's all about adding them points up and getting them fastest, okay? That's the way it works. Okay, so at the end of the round, in fifth place now, we have Mr. Johnson with 1,316 points. Fourth place, still the Beers. You've got 1,469 points. Third place now, the Pecs, 1,531 points. Stomping ahead is a little old drinker, wine drinker me, is 1,774 points. That puts you in second. In first place in that round is Win or Booze, 1,879 points. So, yeah, Win or Booze, little old drink of me, wine drink of me, you spot on. Yeah, keep them points going. Right, so that's round two done. Okay, so round three is general history. How do you like history? I like history, or herstory, it should be called. We need to come up with a different name, don't we, for history? Politically correct. History. Take off. Yes, there we are. So, that's what's history. It could be. Herstory. Oh, yeah, we need to come up with anyway. We'll think of something. Right, start round. Who discovered penicillin? So, on that one, who discovered penicillin? Was it Frederick Banting, Alexander Fleming, Frederick Bayer, or Charles Best? Yeah, so just pick one of them. Remember, the faster you answer it, the more points you're going to get. Tim Carroll said the round was brown in colour. word association, Tim. Yes. Louise said, I agree, Tim. Yes. Yeah. Little brown ice cream emoji. I'm sure it's brown ice cream. Looks like it. So answer was Alexandra Fleming. All of you got that one spot on. Nobody got it wrong. But who got the fastest finger? Mr. Johnson. My cousin Billy, he's on it. Well done. And he's not here, he's up north, so 194 miles away. So I'm not giving him any clues or hints. Right, question two. What year did the Titanic sink? So what year did the Titanic sink? You got a little keypad? You press the buttons. Iceberg, dead ahead. How would you miss that? I have no idea. There you go. And there's plenty of room for Jack on that raft. Does everyone agree? I think you do. Yes. Good, Jack. Right, 26 of you got it right. 10 got it wrong. The answer was 1912. So 1912. So well done, whoever put 1912. Got that points for you. Louise, you got the fastest finger. So well done for getting the answer right and getting the fastest finger. Bonus. Okay, question three. One of the most popular board games ever devised was launched by Parker Brothers in 1935. Which game was it? Okay, is it possible four answers? Which one? Was it Mousetrap, Scrabble, Monopoly, or Cluedo? So the most popular board game ever devised. I should imagine that was pretty easy, that one. Yeah, Monopoly, of course it was. Yeah, 35, you got that one right. One team said Mousetrap, nobody thought it was Scrabble, and one person thought it was Cluedo. Yeah, Monopoly, I mean, it's national, isn't it? It goes everywhere. They've got their own little variations. You've got Liverpool one, you've got Harry Potter ones. Yes, goes on and on. Well done, Gryffindor. You got the fastest finger bonus of that question. Question four, which historic UK Prime Minister was born here? Now, this is a picture, so I'm going to send you a picture. Or a picture. There we are. And then just tell me which historic UK Prime Minister was born there. So was it Margaret Thatcher, Harold Wilson, Anthony Eden, or Winston Churchill? This body brings cider. It's very nice, by the way. So if you do go to Tesco's and buy it, it's Orchard Gold, it's called. It's very nice. The answer was Winston Churchill, 28 of you got it right. That's a majority. So Anthony Eden, 5 of you thought that. Harold Wilson, only 2. Margaret Thatcher was 2 teams as well. But the fastest finger goes to Mrs. Smith. Well done, Mrs. Smith. Let's have a look. Question 5. Who were the other 2 astronauts with Neil Armstrong on the Apollo 11 mission? Yeah, so who were the other two astronauts on the Apollo 11 mission, other than Neil Armstrong, that is? Was it Alan Shepard, Buzz Aldrin, Michael Collins, or James Irwin? So pick two of them. Okay. Answer we're looking for was Buzz Aldrin and Michael Collins. Okay, 15 if you got that right. 22 if you sadly got that one wrong. The fastest finger bonus, though, I know she got it right because she got the fastest finger bonus. Goes Ross. It's the pecs. Well done, the pecs. Yeah, just somebody sent me his message there. There were plenty of room on the raft. She was giving him a cold shoulder. Oh, the pecs said this one. Yeah, she was only giving Jack the cold shoulder. Well done, James. And Louise put LOL, hashtag, or ask James. Yes. Hashtag. There we are. Right, question six. We'll type the number on this one. So Roger Bannister was the first man to run a mile in under 4 minutes in May of which year? There we are. See, this is why, I mean, this quiz says it's on Google. Well, it is Googleable, but the thing is, it'll take you a long time to Google that, as I imagine. The more time it takes you to answer, the less points you get. So you've got to know it. Nothing's on Googleable, but hopefully none of you are doing that. I'm sure that's not the case. So this is why this is fun, this type of quiz. It is going to take you a while to actually do that option if you wanted to. Right, there's 9 if you got this one correct. 28 got it wrong. It was 1954 was the answer. Little old wine drinker me got the fastest finger bonus, and obviously the question right. Well done. Right, question 7. Who was the architect who rebuilt London after the Great Fire of 1666? So who was the architect who rebuilt London after the Great Fire of 1966? 1666. Years after the Battle of Hastings, I know my history. 1066, I'm sure that's right. Someone's going to correct me now and say it wasn't 1066, but it was about Hastings. Yeah, I only know that because I use Hastings insurance. There we are. Right, short answers. It was Christopher Wren. 26 of you got it spot on. One team thought it was Joseph Plaxton. Eight teams thought it was Thomas Cubitt. And two thought it was Henry Holland. Fastest finger bonus goes to Mrs. S. Well done, Mrs. S. Fastest finger bonus. Question 8. The Greek Civil War took place between which two of the following years? Okay, so choose two of these. So we took between... Which of these two? The Greek Civil War, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know not about that one. I do go to Greece quite a lot. Skiathos was very good, Tim. Yes, it was very good. Yes. Lindos, I'm afraid. He's going to put something clever on the side on the comments, so it could be up here. Right, the answer, two of them, we needed 1946 and 1949. Okay, so the fastest finger bonus goes to Paige Brinley. Only 13 of the teams got that one right. 24 of you sadly got it wrong. Not to worry, though. So, like I said, next question is all about the faster finger. Coming up to the end of the round. Okay, question 9. In 2004, the NASA rover Spirit successfully landed on which planet? So the NASA rover Spirit successfully landed on which planet back in 2004? Very quick, that, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not playing the quiz, obviously I'm hosting it, but I would have said Mars. Yeah, was it Mars? Let's have a look. Yes, it was Mars, and 32 of you got that one spot on. Two teams thought it was Saturn, nobody thought it was Venus, and three thought the Moon. Hey, could have been. Yeah, you never know. No, it wasn't. It was Mars. Mr. Johnson, well done, you astronomer, or astronaut lover, or whatever you want to call yourself. Well done, you got your fastest finger on that one. We've got 37 teams now. Another two teams are joining in. Well done, though. Thanks for joining in the quiz. Don't forget next week, 7:30, or a little bit after when I stop waffling. Question 10. Which Pope is in this picture? So I'm going to send you a picture now. Just tell me which Pope it is. He's a worried Pope by the look of it, but which worried Pope was that? Something tragic must have happened. Oh, very quick. Okay. If you said Francis, you were wrong. If you said Paul the Fifth, you got it wrong. If you said Benedict, you got it wrong. It was John Paul the Second. There we are. I didn't know that one. 26 of you said that. That's great. Run sheets. It's plenty. Plenty of points for you. That's what the points are about. There we are. So well done for you guys. The Douse is all the way back up in Redcar. Holmesborough, I'm not sure where you're living at the minute, but it's nice to see some teams from up north. I love it, like I said earlier. And I've got a lot of history with these guys. Yeah. So anyway, question 11. In what year did the Battle of Waterloo take place? Well, then type the number. So in which year did the Battle of Waterloo take place? Tim, I hope Gail and Stan's playing tonight. I hope they're playing. Mary Kelly, I don't know they're playing. No, you said the Douses last week, which does that mean all of you? Or just you and your good lady? And kids. You've got kids? I don't know. Anyway, right, 13 got it right. 24 of you sadly got it wrong. Okay, the answer was 1815. 1815 was the Battle of Waterloo. So make that a mental note when you come to our normal pub quiz. If that comes up, you're going to get it right. Fastest finger was the Bears. There we go. They're back in the game. Back in the game, the Bears. Well done. Right. Don't forget, next question is the evil one. Don't answer it. You're losing points. Answer it wrong. You're losing points. Answer it right. Bonus. That's what it's about. So question 12 is, Golda Meir served as Prime Minister of which country between 1969 and 1974? So Golda, one of them. Meir served as Prime Minister of which country between 1969 and 1974? I have no idea this one myself, ladies and gentlemen, so hopefully you guys do. Right, answer was Israel. 24 of you smashing it. You obviously knew. Everyone knows this one, obviously. 5 thought it was Libya, though. 8 thought it was Egypt. And Norman thought Sudan. Fastest finger, the Bears again. 2 fastest fingers on the row there, ladies and gentlemen. And this is what it's all about, getting them answers in quick but correct. Yes, it's no good just pressing any button to get fastest finger. If you get it wrong, this is it. So, unfortunately, there's 5 and 8 teams getting some points taken off after this round, but not to worry, it's not too drastic. It's only about 20 points, I think, nothing major. So, at the end of the round, in 5th place is now the Pecks. You've got 1,630 points. It is 4th place, we've got Rebel Scum. You've got 1,688 points. 3rd place is our dear old Dave Grifter. You've got 1,699 points. 2nd place, Little Old Wine Me Drink Me, 1,812 points. 1st place, though, the Bears, see, they're after, they're keeping this running title going on, 1,916 points. So there's only 100 points-ish, a little bit ahead. So not to worry, they didn't win the first two rounds. So it's all in it for the next ones, okay? Right, now that is the end of the round, okay? So what we do now, we go for a little bit of a drink, go for the toilet break, or toilet or restroom, wherever you come from. Kiss and cuddle your wife, husband, or whatever you want to do, dog, cat, whatever. And I'll put a little bit of music on. Okay, so we'll go for a little break, 5 minutes. So the time stands at the minute is just gone 20 past. So I say if we meet back here, yes, 21 minutes past. So if we meet you back here at 26 minutes past, we'll do the rest of the rounds. All right. Okay, so I'll put a bit of music on. Go do what you need to do. I'll put you a bit of music. If you like this one. I call myself fight for that white gold. This one for them hood girls, them good girls, straight masterpieces. Styling, violent, living it up in the city. Got chucks on with Saint Laurent, gotta kiss myself, so pretty. Too high, I'm the police and the firemen. I'm too hard, I'm gonna retire, man. I'm too hard. You know, say my name, you know who I am. I'm too high. I'm a band about that one. Girl, sent you hallelujah. Girl, sent you hallelujah. Girl, sent you hallelujah. Cause I'm tell punk, don't give it to you. Cause I'm tell punk, don't give it to you. Cause I'm tell punk, don't give it to you. Saturday night, I'm eating. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just
just mine. Don't believe me, just mine. Don't believe me, just mine. Don't believe me, just mine. Hey, 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 oh!
Wait a minute. Fill my cup, put some nigga in it. Take a sip, sign the check. Coolio, get the stretch.
Right to Harlem, Hollywood, Jackson, Mississippi. If we show up, we gon' show up. Smoother than a fresh drop, skip it.
I'm too hot. Call the police and the firemen. I'm too hot. Make a dragon, but on a retirement. I'm too hot. They say my neck, you know who I am. I'm too hot. Girl said to you, hallelujah. Girl said to you, hallelujah. Girl said to you, hallelujah. Cause uptown funk don't give it to you. Cause uptown funk don't give it to you. Cause uptown funk don't give it to you. Saturday night and we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch. 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 Hey, 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 oh!
Wait a minute. Let me tell y'all a little something. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. I said uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. Come on, dance, jump on it. If you suck, said and flown it. If you freak, get it and own it. Don't worry about the control. Come on, dance, jump on it. If you suck, said and
don't believe me, just watch. 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 Hey, hey, hey.
Just you up with apologies. I hope I don't run out of time. Can someone call a referee? Cause I just need one more shot at forgiveness. I know you know that I made those mistakes maybe once or twice. Not once or twice, I mean maybe a couple of hundred times. So let me, oh, let me redeem, oh, redeem all myself tonight. Cause I just need one more shot, second chance. Is it too late now to say sorry?
Yo! Back in the house, right, let's turn the screen down a bit. Yeah, a little bit. Justin Bieber did it, everyone did it. So I'll tell you what. If I didn't know Justin Bieber was coming on there, I wouldn't have put that on otherwise. Yeah, bit of Bieber in the house. All right, let's just put this screen back to full screen mode. There we are. Big shout out to Quiz B. Good day, Gail. How you doing? And little old wine drinker. Yeah, Dark Horse. There we are. Well, welcome to the quiz anyway. Thanks for letting me know who you are. Hopefully enjoying the quiz. Right, so round three in the bag. So well done to all who played and who's getting the fastest fingers. We've got a few more rounds, like I said, six rounds in total. So let's crack on and see what the next one is, all right? If you want, I can play a little bit more music at the end if you like my playlist. I didn't put it together, it was YouTube. Yes, I'm going to blame them.
Right, so the next round is round four. Okay, so it's a picture this. So it's 12 images, 12 questions, 12 chances to get a fastest finger bonus, okay? That's what it's all about. The faster you answer it, the more points you're going to get. And if you win the 50 quid and you're from up north, when lockdown's over, feel free to come down. And if you're from Wrexham, you're just round the corner in it. So happy days. Good old Nag's Head, best pub in Wrexham. Of course it is. If Carlsberg made pumps, they'd make the Nags. Adam. Anyway, right, round four. Question one. What is the sporting trophy in this picture? Okay, so I'm showing you a picture. So what is that sporting trophy? Yeah, I think Tim C might get this one quickest. I'm confident that Tim C is going to get this quickest. Actually, I take that back. I actually thought that was a rugby trophy, but yeah, take it back. But you all took a little bit longer than I anticipated you answer that one. If you put Super Bowl, which was the other week, wasn't it? 18 of you did. You got it absolutely spot on. 9 people thought it was a Davis Cup. Davis Cup? Isn't that golf? There's a bit of a big ball there, ladies and gentlemen. If you put six said Stanley Cup, and 2 thought the WNBA Championship. A few messages there. And we've got Louisa, that definitely means Johnny Depp, right though. Yes, you know, Tim said he got it right though. He did get it right, so even though it wasn't rugby, he got it right. So, how many of you watched the Super Bowl last week? I wasn't staying up at that time of night. But if you're a fat boy though, you could have got a present delivered as food for a charge and nothing free like we do. There we are. Any of you from North East don't know, it's my rival pub across the road. I love mocking them. I love them a bit, so. So any of you guys are playing from the football, welcome to the quiz. I do love your pub. She's still my rival. There you are. Anyway, next one. Name the TV newsreader. Sorry, I didn't come up with the fastest finger on that one, but whoever got the fastest finger, you'll get the bonuses. So who is this newsreader? Send you some possible answers. Is it Fiona Bruce, Sophie Rower, Jane Hill, or Katie Silverton? All right, okay. Answer was, is Katie Silverton. 15 of you's got that one right. 3 people thought it was Jane Hill, 5 thought it was Sophie Raworth, and 12 thought it was Fiona Bruce. I didn't recognise them then, gents, so not to worry about that too much. Fastest finger goes to Dasval. Well done, Dasval. Fastest finger bonus for you straight off. Boom. Question 3. Name the brand from the logo. Now I'm going to send you a picture or a picture. Will you just tell me what brand it is? There we are. What brand is that? Is it possible? Is it Asiax, Adidas, or Adidas, Asos, or Aldo? Very fast, ladies and gentlemen. Obviously, you know your logos. If you put Adidas, you'll be wrong. If you put Asos, you'll be wrong. If you put Aldo, you were wrong. But 30 of you says Asiax. Asiax. I don't recognize that brand myself. But obviously, 30 of you did. The fastest finger bonus, though, is Quiz on My Face. Well done, Quiz on My Face. Right, question 4. Name the classic cartoon character. So again, I'm going to send you a picture. So what is this classic cartoon character? Oh, easy peasy. Easy peasy. My old friend from up north, Lisa Corlin. I haven't seen him for a long time. Yeah, long time. Yep, I couldn't say his name, but if I said Martin, he might give you a clue. Because it was Marvin the Martian. Of course it was. 30 people got that right. One thought is Booster. I don't know who Booster is. One thought Bleep. Again, no idea who Bleep is. George Jetson. Really? 3 of you said that one. Never mind. We don't mock anyone. But 3 of you said George Jetson. The fastest finger goes to Run Sheets. Plenty of points. Again, I love that one. That's my new thing there. Plenty of points every time we do that one. Right, question 4. Name the tennis player. So again, I'm going to send you a picture. All you got to do is answer it right. Okay, so who is this tennis player? Looks like the girl who jacked off the raft. Yeah, James, you just left a message. Oh, this makes me very angry. And Louis said, what's up, James? Yeah, what's up, James? What makes you angry? other than the pub being shut and we can't serve all our lovely patrons. Life's too short to be angry. Right, somebody's leaving James a message over here. Right, okay, if you put Steffi Graf, you'd be wrong. If you put Monica Sales, you'd be wrong. If you put Martina Navratilova, you'd be wrong. It was Maria Sharapova. Marina Sharapova. Fastest finger goes to Paige Brindley. Well, James has answered the question why he's angry. Marvin the Martian, it is his catchphrase. Oh, okay. Oh, I didn't know that one. Oh, now I do. Oh, well, there you go. Now we know you're not angry. You're just quoting Marvin the Martian. My old friend from back north is called Martin. We used to call him Martin the Martian. Well, kids. You know, it doesn't make much sense. He wasn't an alien. Or was he? Maybe. Question six. Name the European city. So this picture of a city, I need to know what it is or where it is. Should be easy enough. Yeah, it's quite easy, that one. Is it Bruges, Gothenburg, Amsterdam or Venice? Oh, fast. I didn't even get a chance to pick my beer up, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for stopping for drinking, because it's bad for you. I don't know. That's why you're answering quick. Right. Okay. If you said Bruges, you said wrong. Gothenburg was wrong. Amsterdam was wrong. Venice was the answer we're looking for. So 22 said that. 11 said Amsterdam. Nobody thought Gothenburg. And two for you, thought it was Bruges. The canals were a little bit of a clue there, I think. Tim Cedar, well done. If you haven't been to Venice, a lot of people slate it, saying it's smelly. I don't think that's the truth, because I've been there in the height of summer, and it was a lovely place to go. Lots of churches, if you like that sort of thing, but lots of nice little cafes. Just take a credit card. But it is a very nice place to stay. I can, if you want to say any advice on a little chateau to stay in, I can give you that. Okay, it was cheap as chips. Oh, someone's beeping me. Nope, I'm going to turn that one off because we're playing a quiz. This isn't about me texting. Anyway. Right, question seven. Name the classic children's game. So this picture, I just need you to name the classic children's game. So what is that? Easy peasy, ladies and gentlemen. Every one of you had this game, regardless of your age. One of you who played this or had it at one point in your life. That's why it took 2 seconds to answer. Well done. So it was obviously Hungry Hippos, and 33 of it got it bang on. Only two said Hamster Race, and no one said Animal Magic, and nobody thought Operation Pet Scan. Is that a game? I don't know. Anyway, fastest finger bonus goes to the wins. Welcome back to Quiz Wins. Love it. Okay, we did have two teams have dropped out. Must be a poor quiz tonight, I think. Must be letting you guys down. Two people have dropped out. Or the pieces arrive, which usually happens. I'm going to go with the pieces arrived. Okay, question eight. Name the England international footballer. And I know you're in Wales, but we've got a lot of English playing tonight as well. So name the England international footballer. There's a picture. And here's your possible four answers. Is it Peter Shilton, David James, Ray Clements, or Gordon Banks? Gordon Banks. Hey. Hmm. I like Gordon Banks, and if I've said that out before you got the answers, hopefully it's not Gordon Banks. No, it was Ray Clements. So 5 of you said Gordon Banks, though, so you're on the same page as me. 18 said Ray Clements, so well done, you got it right. 3 of you got it sadly wrong, it was David James. And 9 said Peter Shilton, so you got that one wrong as well. Never mind, no. Grifter, you got a fastest finger bonus for that answer. Well done. Okay, question 9. Name the UK city. So I'm going to send you a picture again. Obviously, because it's a picture out. What is this UK city? Don't know that one myself, but you got possible Glasgow, Newcastle, Hull, or Liverpool. Which one is it? Okay, quite quick. I like that. It was Hull. Yes, 12 of you said Hull. 9 thought it was Liverpool, 8 thought Newcastle, and 6 thought Glasgow. Did the wife say Glasgow? No, she didn't say Glasgow. I can hear her in the front room. Apparently, she popped her head in while I was having my little vape break there. So if you've seen Steph giving her a wave, you can't say hello back. But she likes a bit of attention. She's been cooped up in here as long as I have. We're going to be a little crazy. There we are. Right. So question 10. If you saw this logo, what app would you be opening or using? Easy peasy, that one. Right, so what would it be? Would it be LinkedIn, WhatsApp, Fiverr? Never heard that one. Or FaceTime? Oh, click again. Okay, yeah, obviously WhatsApp. 35 of you said that, so you all got it right. Yeah, I've never heard of Fiverr. Have you heard of Fiverr? Anyway, it wasn't the answer anyway. Linz, oh, well done, Linz. Fastest finger bonus for you. Yes, Fiverr. Somebody send me a message. What it is. Question 11. Which movie did this car appear in? So it's another one. Picture, I'm going to send you it now. So what movie did it appear in? If anyone gets this one wrong, well, nothing I can do. It's just be a bit odd if you got it wrong. So, okay, well, quite quick, everyone answered. No, nobody answered this one wrong. So it wasn't Batman, it wasn't Terminator, it wasn't Repo Man. Of course, it was Ghostbusters. And the new Ghostbusters movie is coming out this year, and it looks amazing. If you haven't seen the trailer, go on YouTube after this and Google Ghostbusters 2021. It looks great. Not like the other crap they've actually released after Ghostbusters 2. It's really good. Yeah. Opinion, that's all it is. Check it out anyway. Right, don't forget, next question is the evil question. So if you answer it wrong, you know you're going to lose points. If you don't answer it, you're going to lose points. So answer it, but answer it right. Okay, so fastest finger bonus still stands, so you can get extra points for that as well. Right, question 12 is, what does this UK road sign mean? Now, if this is the same we had last week, you should all get it right. Oh, no, it's not. It's different from last week. So which road sign is this? What does it mean? Okay, is it no overtaking, cars prohibited, queues likely, three-lane carriageway? Now, the reason I said that at the beginning, because we've had a few repeat questions tonight, which I thought, but I did notice there was two or three questions in there we've had last week, I think. Obviously not the Corolla colour board. We've gone through that, haven't we, Paige? There we are. Right, so it was queues likely. 28 of you said that. Only one person thought it was carriageway, three-lane carriageway, and 6 thought it was no overtaking. But no, it was queues likely on that one. But push it upper. Got it faster. Upper faster. Well done. Right, so at the end of rounds, you are now in fifth place. We got Rebel Scum. Okay, if no one gets that, it's Star Wars reference. You should all get that reference. That's a laser gun, whatever they're called. Rebel Scum will correct me on the real terminology for that gun. Fourth is Mrs. Smith, 1,807 points. Third place, we have Team Anzar. Welcome back to Team Anzar. That was one of our reigning champions over the lockdown one. 1,835 points. In second place is Beers, again, one of our champions, 1,933 points. When first place is the Pex with 2,134 points. So smashing it ahead. Not a lot, only 199 points. Not too bad. Well done, the Pex, though. Like I said, keep it up, guys, because it's all about the next couple of rounds, all right? So fastest finger, the better. Okay, but get it right, though. No point in pressing willy-nilly to get the fastest finger. Right, well, the next round, round 5, is sitcoms. I did say I was going to throw a few of these in there last week, so I love sitcoms. I'm sure I'll be watching a lot of TV over the last 1, 2, or 3 lockdowns, so we should be quite up on it. Read a few of these messages. Tim Carroll said, Fiverr, you can pitch prices for work. Oh, okay, all right, so it's a work job site. Gun in Star Wars is called a blaster. All right, thanks, Stephen. It's a blaster. Of course it was. Yes. On the deck with Peck. On the deck with Peck, Mr. Butterhead. All right, okay, that's cool. That's my message, John. A blaster, of course it was. Right, sitcoms. In The Office, what is the name of the paper company David Brent works for? So was it Perkins Paper, Wareham Hog, Hog Enterprises, or Pendleby Pockets? Page release. The message on your phone is off Linz. Can't comment on YouTube. All right, I'll reply to Linz after this, okay? Okay, everyone's taken a full 20 seconds for that one. The answer was Wareham Hog. 17 if you got that right. 7 thought it was Perkins Paper, 9 thought Hog Enterprises, and 2 thought it was Pendlebury Pockets. All right, but the fastest finger bonus is Quiz on My Face. Well done, Quiz on My Face. So, right, so question two, name the classic BBC sitcom. I'm sending you a picture now. Oh, yes, I know this one. I know this one. I'm not playing though, so it doesn't matter. But do you know it? So is it Rosie, Zedcar's Waterfront Beat on a Thin Blue Line? Okay, quite quick. I like that. Yep, Thin Blue Line it was. Of course it was. 33 people thought that one. What did Louis say? Two people thought it was Waterfront Beat. No, before Zedcar's, yeah, way before that. Rosie never heard of that program. Nobody thought that anyway. Zaz Val got the fastest ring of bonus for that one. Louisa sent a message and join the piece, Chris, if Lynn's can't chat. Of course, but I always love a bit of correspondence between me and you. So I will reply as much as I can, read them out. But I'll reply to Lynn's later anyway, be fine. Right, so what question one? Three. What year did sitcom The Royal Family first air on BBC Two? So what year? Just type in the year you think The Royal Family first aired on BBC Two. Well, it looks like the majority of you are up under your old Royal Family here. I can see you counting there. So 24 of you got... Oh, no, sorry, upside down. 24 got it wrong. No, it was 12 only got this one right. The answer was 1998, ladies and gentlemen. 1998. Horn Sheets got it absolutely spot on. You left school about that year, didn't you, Tim? Yeah, you're watching The Royal Family. You should have been out playing with your mates. Let's have a look. I'm sure you were. I'll listen to a bit of Guns N' Roses, something like that. So anyway, question four, name the BBC sitcom. So I'm going to send you a picture or a picture. Yeah, so what is this BBC sitcom? Not even time to swallow the drink. Right, okay, if you'd said My Family, you'd be wrong. 2.4 children, totally wrong. Not going out. One person said that. So I'll be wrong. It was Outnumbered. 31 of you said that one. So well done. You got that one right. Louise, you got it fastest finger though. So extra bonus for you, Louise. So what up? Question five. In which English county is the Vicar of Dibley based? So the Vicar of Dibley, what county is it based in? Sorry, I was reading the questions there. No one's messaged me. The answer was Oxfordshire. 16 of you said that. 7 said Kent. 7 said Warwickshire. And 6 said Cambridgeshire. But no, it's Oxfordshire we're looking for. Fifi, well done, Fifi. You got the fastest finger there. So question six, name the classic sitcom. So again, I'm going to send you a picture and just tell me what it is. Easy peasy. There we are. I should imagine no one will get this one wrong, but I might be wrong myself. Maybe you didn't like that type of comedy. If you didn't, why? Why? Why didn't you like that comedy? It was Men Behaving Badly, and 36 got it right. There was nobody got this one wrong. So, yeah, of course it wasn't Doc Martin or Goodnight Sweetheart or Man About the House. Good old Men Behaving Badly. Kylie World. If you hadn't bought the book when it first got released, that programme, Kylie World is awesome. If you buy the book, I'm sure it's available on good purchases such as Amazon or eBay. The book's fantastic. Anyway, question seven. In the sitcom Benidorm, what is the name of the Spanish hotel? I've never seen this program once, so I don't know, but hopefully you guys do. So what is the name of the Spanish hotel in Benidorm? Never been to Benidorm. I've never fancied it. Never will, I don't think. I'm sure a lot of you people love it, but it's never been one of my go-to places. The answer was Solana. 32 of you got it right. Soup team says Senorita. One for Solo and one for Solar. Fastest finger bonus goes to Paige Brinley. Well done, Paige. I have seen adverts in the programme. That's why I didn't really want to go to Benidorm, you know. But hey-ho, I'm sure it's a great place. Okay, question 8. Dad's Army gave us many catchphrases, but which of the following two were from the series? So Dad's Army, if you know it, which two of these catchphrases were from the series? I love Dad's Army. What do you?
Which one?
Do you think that's wise? I'm a cunning plan, don't tell him Pike. Oh, let's be careful out there. Okay, so let's see if you got it right. Okay, do you think that's wise was the right answer, and don't tell him Pike. Yes. I think that's slightly wrong, though, because I'm sure it's like, don't tell him your name, Pike. I'm sure that was the catchphrase, but generally about the same thing. 12 of you got it right. Sadly, 24 got it wrong. Fastest finger bonus goes to Fifi. Well done, Fifi. Question 9. What is the name of the ship's computer in Red Dwarf? See, that I would have got this one right straight away. Yeah, so is it Holly, Ivy, Fred, or Rimmer? Yeah, there was a classic. There was two people played the computer in the series. But is it Holly? Oh, you've all answered. So, of course, it was Holly. Yeah, two people thought it was Ivy. Three people thought it was Fred, and four thought Rimmer. Yes, no, but it was Holly. Yes, played by a man and a woman. Yeah, it was a great series. It was better in the original days, but like all series are on TV, they always get a budget and they ruin it, don't they? It's a bit like Star Wars. As soon as it got a budget, it went SGI, where it's called, it ruined it. Yes, back in the old days, the originals were the best. But Holly was the answer we're looking for anyway. And the fastest finger bonus goes to Mr. Johnson, Billy. Well done. Right. The Blackadder was the first series of Blackadder. What year did the show originally air? So Blackadder, what year did it originally air? Another classic. See, that never got spoiled, in my opinion. It never got a massive budget. It was always a level par all the way through. But outstanding comedy. People like Stephen Fry and obviously Baldrick. Yes. Let's have a look. 10 sadly got this from... 10 got it right. Yeah, 26 you got this from wrong. The year was 1983. Yeah, I was 4-year-old, ladies and gentlemen. I still know that one. Well, there you go. Yeah, I love Blackadder. Fastest finger goes to Mrs. Johnson. Oh, yeah, Mrs. Johnson got it wrong. Yeah, slap him, Louise. Slap him. Louise, never seen it. Never seen. James says, never seen it. Louise Myers, I love Red Dwarf. Louise Myers, James, watch it. It's hilarious. It is hilarious. Never seen it. Seriously, there's, I think it's 5 series of them. I think 5. Yeah, maybe wrong with that one. But anyway, question 11. Absolutely Fabulous follows two women gracefully growing old called what? So is it Patsy, Saffron, Fleur, or Edina? So is it Patsy, Saffron, Fleur, or Edina? I didn't like the show, it's just not something I would have watched all the time. It was really, it was on gold, I'd watch it. Tim Cow just says smeg, smeg. See, if you know Red Dwarf, you're that episode. It's not me trying to make a double chin because I've already got one, and I got a triple chin on that one. But yes, Tim, smeg. There we are. Right. Answer was Patsy and Edina. Edina and Patsy. That was the answer. 29 of you got that one right. 6 of you sadly got it wrong. Sorry, guys. But the fastest thing goes to the Smeg. Yeah, I've just said Smeg, so I was reading this. The Pex. Yeah. Cheers, Louise. Smeghead. Hang my head in shame, as you said. Okay, right, next question is the evil question, and I'm not going to repeat it, you know what it's about. Just answer it right, ladies and gents, and get it fastest. Okay, question 12. What is the name of Smithy and Nessa's son in Gavin and Stacey? Now, a lot of you guys are from Wales. You should get this one straight away. I'm guessing the ones who are from the north won't get it. Do we watch it up north? I don't know. It was an all right program. You guys loved it. I thought it was all right. The answer was Neil. Yeah, 31 of you got it right, so it's 31 seeing and guaranteeing from Wales. 2 fought Nev, 3 fought Noel, and nobody fought Nick. But on question 12, the evil question, Paige Brinley, and Paige just texted me, Neil the baby. Is that Neil the babe, or is he fit or something, or is he just a kid? I don't know. I haven't watched it really that much. But anyway, you got a fastest finger bonus on that one, so well done. Right, so the end of that round. In fifth place now, we have Winner Booze, 1,703 points. Just ahead is, in fourth place, is Quizbees. Good girl. 1,707 points, so only four ahead, sorry, maths was terrible there. Third place is the Beers, 1,789 points. In second place is Little Old Wine Drinking Me, Kelly D. There we are, you got 1,837 points, smashing it. In first place, though, is Fifi. Not all Fifi, the owner of the jacket. Yes, the sparkly jacket, that is. 1,848. If I got that wrong, if Fifi's now changed the name to someone else playing, my apologies, but I'm sure it's Jane. Fifi, sure that's right. Anyway, you're in first place, so well done. But that doesn't mean you're winning. You've got about the next round. So all them points get put together. So the more rounds you win, obviously, the better your chances of winning. And this next round is going to be about the fastest finger, because you need to get them points in there, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to get this 50 quid bar tab. And like I said, if you're not from around here, you can use it when you travel down to come and see me and Stephanie. All right. Because we haven't seen a lot of people for 2 years now. Believe it or not, I was speaking to my mum the other day and she said, I haven't seen you for 2 years. And I said, really? It's true. Last time when we got married, that was last time we were home. We haven't broke any rules. So, yeah, it's been a long time for us, guys. And this is why I appreciate you guys and girls playing the quiz and keeping me occupied every week. And I keep you entertained every week. But, yeah, it's been a long time since I've seen anyone. So let's crack on anyway. Round six, music. Do you like music? We all love music. So this is a music mix. So I'm guessing what we're going to do, we're going to mash up a couple of songs. It's going to be a couple of lyrics and stuff like that. And you've just got to get them right, okay? And then you can all go about your night after this and get mightily drunk, because you've got nothing to do tomorrow, unless you're at work, because you're key staff, okay? Right, round six, question one. Justin Timberlake started his career as a member of which band? Yeah, so which band did Justin Timberlake first start with? Was it 3T, Backstreet Boys, NSYNC, or New Kids on the Block? Don't count Disney. Yeah, Disney, don't count that one. Okay, right, so NSYNC. Now, I think that's slightly wrong, because I'm sure it was it was NSYNC, wasn't it? Yeah, NSYNC, yeah, 32, you got it right. Two people thought it was Backstreet Boys. I remember Backstreet Boys, it wasn't them guys. New Kids on the Block, that was New Kids on the Block, sorry. And nobody thought 3T, I think that was a British band. Mr. Johnson, though, well up on your boy bands, mate. A bit worried. But happy days. Fastest finger, though. Yeah, well done, Mr. Johnson. Question two. What decade is Christina Aguilera's hit single, What a Girl Wants, from? So what decade was What a Girl Wants from? The 1990s, 2000s, 2010s, or 2020s? What a girl wants, what a girl needs. Yeah. I remembered it, but I wouldn't say it was something I had on my Casio cassette player back in the days. Millennials, Casio cassette players were top of the range back then. If you said 99s, you'd be spot on. 25, you did like. 2008 said the noughties. Two people thought it was 2010s, and nobody thought it was 2020s. Obviously, she hadn't released anything because she's crap. There we are. Daz Valdo, you did get the fastest finger bonus for that one. It was released in 1998, to be exact, if you wanted to know. I didn't know it because I like Christina Aguilera. I just knew it because it came up on here. Yeah. Oh, the wife's just corrected me. She said it's 1999. So, in fact, Quizbit has got that one wrong. But it was still the 1990s. There was no other options. But I shall bring that up with the people at Quizbit tomorrow. Right, anyway, question three, name the singer and TV judge. So I'm going to send you a picture now. So just tell me what the singer and the TV judge is. Yeah, the wife will get this one right, I think. I won't tell you what program it is, but I do actually know what program it is because I watch it with the wife. Quite a good show, I like it. Even with no contestants, audience at the minute. But it was Anne Marie, yeah, 25, we got that one right. 2-4 people thought it was Ellie Goulding, 7-4 was Pixie Lott, and 2 people thought it was Meghan Trainor, you know, Anne Marie, which we've seen quite a few years ago now when we went to see Phil Collins. Was it Phil Collins? Ed Sheeran, sorry, it wasn't Phil Collins, no, that was Goldie. We went to see Ed Sheeran, and Anne Marie was supporting act, and she was very good. Never heard of her before that, but she was spot on. Push It Upper. Got the fastest finger on that one. Well done. Question four. What year did ABBA win Eurovision Song Contest? So in what year did ABBA win the Eurovision Song Contest? It's nice having memories before lockdown anyway. So, yeah. Going back when we could actually do stuff. We were all crammed in the concert arena. It was great times. Yeah. 12 of you got it right. 24 of you sadly got that one wrong. The year was 1974. Mrs. S, so well done, Mrs. S. Surely too young to remember that, Mrs. S. But well done. So, right, question five. Name the 1994 debut studio album by Oasis. The wife's going to get this straight away. So, name the 1994 debut stadium album by Oasis, or studio album, sorry. Was it What's the Story, Morning Glory, There and Then, Definitely Maybe, or Wibbling Rivalry? Wibbling Rivalry? Never heard of that one. The answer was Definitely Maybe. 26 years spot on there. 10 of you said What's the Morning Story, Glory. See, I was going to say that as well. Nobody fought There and Then, and nobody fought Wibbling Rivalry. Fastest finger, though, goes to Dave Grifter. Well done, Dave. Right, moving on. Right, so the question, I'm going to be computers froze. What's going on there? Little asterisk on it. Question six. Yes, name this 70s band. So now I'm going to send you a picture. Picture. So name this 70s band. What were they called? Here's the possible four options. Was it The Real Thing, The Stylistics, The Drifters, or The Tramps? Okay, quite quick for you guys. It was The Real Thing. Yeah, 13 of you said The Real Thing. 6 said Stylistics, 16. A lot of you thought it was The Drifters, and 1 thought it was The Tramps. So I don't know any of them apart from The Drifters and Stylistics. So, yeah, I would have got it wrong as well. But if you got The Real Thing, you got it right. Paige Brinley did, and she got the fastest finger bonus for that one. Okay, so question seven. Put these Pet Shop Boys singles in release order earliest first. Millennials are not going to get this one, but give it a go anyway. So put these Pet Shop Boys singles in release order from the earliest to first. Great one. Okay. Right, it took you all 20 seconds to answer that one, so some of you weren't too sure. It was, first, we needed West End Girls. Second was Suburbia. Third was It's a Sin. And the fourth would have been Left on My Own Devices. Fastest finger bonus went to Fifi. And only four people got this one right, all four teams even. 32 sadly got that one wrong. The way it goes, if you want to know, 1984 was West End Girls. 1986 was Suburbia. 1987, It's a Sin, It's a Sin, remember? 1988 was Left on My Own Devices. And I'm sure that was probably the last time. Shame though, Pet Shop Boys were great. Right, moving on anyway. Question eight. Which American rock band had a hit in the 80s with The Eye of the Tiger? I don't even need to think about that one. Hopefully you guys and girls don't need to know. Even. Was it Heart, Survivor, Toto, or Kiss? Heart, Survivor, Toto, or Kiss? Okay. 33 of you said Survivor was just spot on. One thought Heart, two thought Toto, nobody thought Kiss. But yeah, Survivor. Yeah, Eye of the Tiger. Mrs. Johnson, well done there, Mrs. Johnson. Fastest winger for you. Question 9. How many different members of the Sugar Babes have there been? Oh, tricky. So I typed the right number. So how many different members of the Sugar Babes have there been? Okay. Well answered no, yeah. Okay, well 10 of you, I can tell you got that right. 25 of you sadly got that one wrong though. The answer was 6. There's been six original members, not original, a different member of the Sugar Babes. Yeah. Fastest finger though, Mr. Johnson. I'm worried about you there, Billy. You know a lot about bands, especially boys and girl bands. There we are. Oh, there was one team that answered there. Oh, never mind. So, look, question 10. Which pop star's real name is Peter Jean Boyett Hernandez? So, which one of them? Is it Mark Ronson, Pharrell Williams, Bruno Mars, or MC Hammer? So, Peter Jean Boyett Hernandez. Hernandez. All right, okay, well, you're quite quick on that one. It was Bruno Mars. Yeah, 28, yes, spot on. 3 only thought it was MC Hammer, and 3 thought Pharrell Williams, and 2 thought Mark Ronson. Fastest finger, though, goes to Paige Brinley. Well done, getting that one. Question 11. Which band did this singer find fame? So in which band did this singer find fame? Here's a picture. Easy peasy. I love this one. Love Song for a Vampire. Here we are. Okay, let's have a look. They've got a good memory. A Rhythmics, 35. Only one thought was Yazoo. Yazoo? Wasn't that 90s, I think, Yazoo? Well, nobody thought it was Dollar, and no one thought Shakespeare's sister anyway, so that's good. Pemsey, well done, Pemsey. You got the fastest finger on that one. Annie Lennox, it was obviously was, and it was the Rhythmics, yeah. Absolutely fantastic. Right, evil question. Which celebrity auditioned for Boyzone but never got accepted? I know this one. Right, which one was it? Was it Colin Farrell, Chris O'Dowd, Neil Harron, or Nick Bryan? Now, I know this question is slightly wrong, actually. The answer was Colin Farrell. Yeah, 24 people got that one right. 3 people thought Chris O'Dowd. 3 people thought Niall Horan. And 6 people thought it was Nicky Bryan. Colin Farrell. Actually, this is quite wrong, this one, because Colin actually got accepted and he turned it down because he got a message from a movie studio in Hollywood and he offered him a different position and he chose the Hollywood position over the band. Now, I know that as a fact, not because I followed Colin Farrell, I just know it all in general. But yeah, that's why he wasn't in the band and it was Ronan Keating. Yeah, interesting quiz fact. And I didn't read that off there. It's just something I will be here. Random. Totally random. Grifter, though. Well done, Grifter. You got the fastest finger on that one. So, at the end of the round, in fifth place, we got Little Old Wine Drinker Me. Okay, you've got 1,527 points. Fifth place is Fifi, 1,551 points. Third place, Quizbees, good old Gail, 1,675 points. Second place, Team Anzar, or Mr. Team Anzar, they've changed the name, 1,846 points. And just ahead is Mrs. S. You got first place, 1,855. The wife wants to know where she came in that round. Let's have a look. It only shows me the top 10, my sweet, and you're not in it. Oh, what? Never mind. We'll see what happens at the end of the round scoring. Oh, someone's in trouble. Right, anyway, she's playing by herself, though, so I'll let her off. Right, so at the end of the round, quiz fight confernal, we need to know what the score is for the entire quiz. Like I said, all those scores were individual. So we're going to put them all together, amalgamate the scores, and see what happens. So leaderboard, drum roll. There you go. Right. In fifth place, we've got Quizbees. Quizbees, 8,634 points. Fourth place, we have the Pecs, 8,736 points. Third place, Winner Booze, we got 9,320 points. Second place, Little Old Wine Drinker Me, 9,467 points. Well done. And first place, though, where have they come from? The Beers, second week on the run. They're on fire, the Beers. Got 9,934 points, ladies and gentlemen. That's a whopping 500 points plus above. You know what I mean? That's great. Well done, Phil and Annie, though. Well done. The wife says she's come 33rd. Now, that, how's that possible? You didn't answer them right. How is it possible? You didn't get them right. But there you go. But it's not about winning. It's about taking part, ladies and gentlemen. And this is why I like it. This is why I do it every week. And I'm sure this is why you keep doing it. A bit of fun. It breaks up the night a bit. Now you can go get absolutely trolleyed and listen to music till the early hours of the morning. And you've probably got nothing to do tomorrow. And if you have got work tomorrow, get to bed nice and early. But look, anyway, we play this nationally. So let's see where you are all nationally. Oh, well, apparently one of our players came fifth. Okay, who was it though? Again, it didn't tell me. Right, okay. For some reason, it should have come up on your phone or device. I'm going to try and log in again to see who actually came fifth. So, mighty quiz. There we are. Quiz we just played. Leaderboard. Fifth place, the Beers. The Beers came fifth. Okay, so the top score was in Pontefract. Now, a friend of mine used to have a pub in Pontefract, but they scored the Beers. So don't be too clever or cocky. You scored 9,934 points. The top scorer for that actual quiz was 11,244 points. That was the mischievous Blueberry. Yes, back in open Pontefract. So it's all about the fastest finger, ladies and gents, and that's how easy it is to score. But yeah, no, well done. We're in the top five. That's good. And if obviously the Beers won the quiz this week, and we'll see who wins it next week. Hopefully you enjoyed it. I'm going to read a few of these messages. Good little quiz challenge. Annie Lennox from Poyth Rhythm. Oh, apparently, Annie Lennox, if you didn't know, was actually from Poyth, and the rhythm is recorded in Wrexham Studios, where we live. I do believe last time we went for a bike ride, you pointed out the actual little hut he used to record into him. I do remember that, which is amazing, isn't it? Oh, things like the Rhythmics recording in a little town like Wrexham. We've got singers from, we've got Chris Rea, haven't we, guys? Up in Redcar. Chris Rea, yeah. Saltburn, we've got Whitesnake. Spot on. Well, the drum was from Saltburn anyway. Hayley Bowden, are you joining our quiz with Steph on Thursday? Yes, yes, I will. I will, Hayley. I'll do that one. Paul Roberts says, cheers, Chris. Thank you very much. Hashtag legend. Always here to help and keep you sane, guys. Tim Carl, the colours killed my score. Great quiz, as always. Beer and music now. Yes, he's going to get drunk and he'll probably ring me in a bit and we'll have a good old chat. Tim Carl, yep. Yeah, he's just put yep. Paul Roberts says, where's the cat? In not that exact pronunciation. She's disappeared. She's gone off the sparkly jacket. But the other two cats are somewhere as well, usually sleeping, and I want to wake up about 12 o'clock at night when I'm going to bed. But no, again, guys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for joining me with the quiz. It's always nice to see new faces. So please keep liking and sharing this. If you haven't subscribed to the YouTube channel, please subscribe to it. I'm going to start making more use out of the YouTube channel for things like advertising and events and things like that. It's a platform I've not used in the past, but looking at the response we're getting, even had a comment from America the other day. It was a lady who advertises like clothes, like Depop and things like that. And she put, love this. She hasn't, I don't think she's actually played the quiz. And if she has, fantastic. Just send me a message if you're watching this now. And I'll subscribe to your channel as well. Even though I don't buy many clothes or items, I just stick with my clothes from the 80s. still wearing them. But no, thanks again, ladies and gents. Like next week when I put this post up there, please like and share it. Let's try and get the teams up from 34. Yeah, we've got a few more quizzes of this, and I'm probably guessing about 8 more quizzes. So I'm going to be here as long as you want me to do it. And for now, good night, God bless, and I love you all. Okay, cheers again.